Hello students, today we are supposed to discuss the content of quantitative aptitude, a part of quantitative aptitude which we refer as maths. As you all are aware, quantitative aptitude is divided into three parts: maths 40 marks, stats 40 marks and logical reasoning 20 marks. We will be having a detailed discussion of various chapters of mathematics which will help you not only revise during the course of your revision, but also it will provide you a last minute revision for your exam which is supposed to be held in November. The first topic which we are supposed to take is differential and integral calculus, which we also call as derivatives and integration. Now first, let us analyze what are the different ways in which the question can be asked. Now students, differential calculus, the word suggests that we are differentiating a function with respect to x. But when you are supposed to solve a question, they can use different terminologies for the same word derivative. The terminologies which are used for derivative are slope, or gradient, or differential coefficient. Even if you are a non-math student, if you go through this revision lecture, it will provide you enough impetus to score good marks in a part of quantitative aptitude which is mathematics. So in the exam, the word derivative can be asked as slope or gradient or differential coefficient. Derivative is denoted by dy by dx or f dash x or y1. Now friends, as all of us are aware, the standard material which we use is ICI module. So whenever you will see questions of derivatives, sometimes in the question it will be written as dy by dx, sometimes it will be written as f dash x, sometimes they might specify the same thing as y1. Now derivatives should be studied according to types. The important types which cover almost 70 to 80% of the questions are as follows. The first one, the first type is implicit functions. Now a simple way of remembering implicit function is, in the question you will have x and y together. Whenever you see a question where x and y appear in the same condition, some on LHS, some on RHS, or all terms on LHS, then that becomes a question of implicit functions. Now in implicit functions there are various points. Let us in detail discuss the points which cover all questions of implicit functions. The first point in implicit function is shortcut. Now friends, as all of you are aware, the only thing which is not in our hands on the day of our exam is time. So we will have to utilize time as much as we can and try to find out tricks and techniques to solve majority of the questions in a shorter period of time, so that we can spend time for the other questions which will require time. Now, what is the shortcut in implicit functions? Step 1. Step 1 is, for numerator, you consider x as variable and y as constant. I refer x variable, y constant. Step 2. For a denominator, you go exactly reverse. You consider y as variable, x as constant. So friends, when you come across a question where x and y are together and you are thinking of applying shortcut, the rule is, for numerator, consider x as variable and y as constant. For denominator, consider y as variable and x as constant. Dy by dx is equal to minus of step 1 upon step 2. Means if I want to find dy by dx, it is quite simple. I write the terms according to step 1 in the numerator. I write the terms according to step 2 in the denominator. Let us discuss some examples. X square plus x cube y plus y raised to 4 is equal to 0. Now, because this is a question of x and y together, where we are trying to get the answer using shortcut, our answer will always start with a negative sign. Dy by dx is equal to minus of. Now students, let us recollect. Numerator is step 1 for us. For numerator, you consider x as variable and y as constant. For numerator, consider x as variable and y as constant. For denominator, consider y as variable and x as constant. Now, let us go accordingly. I am interpreting my answer in the numerator. Derivative of x square is 2x. When x cube y are given together, x and y are given together, I write the constant y first. Derivative of x cube is 3x square. Derivative of y raised to 4 in the numerator will be 0 because y is a constant. So, x square derivative is 2x. In the second part, y is a constant. I have written it as it is. Derivative of x cube is 3x square. Derivative of y raised to 4 is 0. Now, let us go in the denominator. In the denominator, we have to go exactly reverse. Derivative of x square in the denominator will be 0. Out of x cube y, x cube is a constant. Derivative of y will be 1. Remember, in the denominator, y is a variable. So whatever rule you apply for x in the numerator, the same rule is applicable for y in the denominator. So derivative of y is 1. Derivative of y raised to 4 is 4y cube. So dy by dx is equal to minus of 2x plus 3x square y upon x cube plus 4y cube. Let us discuss 2-3 more examples. Example 2. Ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0. Now this question represents one of the questions in ICI module. Let us try. Dy by dx is equal to minus of numerator. Remember friends, x is a variable and y is a constant. Now when I say x is a variable means, apart from x, every other alphabet seen for the numerator is a constant. A is a constant. Derivative of x square is 2x. When I take 2hxy except x, everything is a constant. So 2hy into 1. Now when I think of derivative of by square, there is no x in it. So its derivative will be 0. Derivative of 2gx will be 2g into 1, as derivative of x will be 1. Derivative of 2fy will be 0. Derivative of c will be 0. Now let us focus on the denominator. Denominator, for the first term, as there is no y, its derivative will be 0. From the second term, its derivative will be 2hx into derivative of y, which is 1. For the third term, b is a constant. Derivative of y square is 2y. 2gx derivative will be 0, as there is no y. 2fy, 2f is a constant. So 2f into 1. C is a constant, derivative of C will be 0. Now as you know, this is the subject of maths. So wherever reduction is possible, we should reduce the terms. If you observe in this question, you can take 2 common and reduce all the terms. So it will be AX plus HY plus G upon HX plus by plus f. My dear students, when you will check the options, many a times in the options the denominator may not be given. If the denominator is not given in the options, that same denominator may be given in the numerator with power minus 1. Yes friends, so that denominator can be written in the numerator with power minus 1. So that will become minus of AX plus HY plus G into HX plus by plus f raised to minus 1. These are the small things which you have to keep in mind while solving the MCQs. Let us take third example. Whenever log is given in the question, say for example log of xy is equal to x square plus y square. Whenever log is given, our priority will be to see to it whether a property of log is applicable or not.
If a property of log is applicable, we should, which may not be a compulsion, but if it is applicable, we should first apply it and make it simple. In differential and integral calculus, many a times property of log will be applicable, which will make our question very, very simple. This I can write it as log x plus log y minus x square minus y square is equal to 0. The property which we have used over here is log of ab is log a plus log b. Now dy by dx is equal to minus of 1 upon x minus 2x, denominator 1 upon y minus 2y. If we take LCM, cross multiply 1 minus 2x the whole upon x upon 1 minus 2y square the whole upon y, which can be written as minus of y into 1 minus 2x square upon x into 1 minus 2y square. Now friends, many a times while solving options or checking the options, there is a confusion as to which option we should mark. Remember, if our denominator appears in the option, shift the negative sign to the numerator. One way of this answer is y into 2x square minus 1. I am keeping the denominator intact because in some options I have seen my denominator, or if I see my numerator in the options, then I shift the negative sign in the denominator. So this will become y into 1 minus 2x square upon x into 2y square minus 1. So there is no such compulsion as to in which form the answer will be given. If negative sign is given, it will be as per our answer. If our denominator appears, minus sign will be shifted in the numerator. If our numerator appears, minus sign will be shifted in the denominator. So friends, we are discussing implicit functions where x and y are together. Let me just retell you the method. Our answer starts with a negative sign. Numerator, x is a variable, y is a constant. Denominator, y is a variable, x is a constant. This was the first point of implicit function, which is shortcut. The second point. Infinity. The moment you see a symbol of infinity, keeping the basic function as it is, substitute the repeated condition as y. For example, y is equal to root of x plus root of x up to infinity. If I check my right hand side, it is starting with root. The moment root reappears, I should re-substitute it as y. So this becomes y is equal to root of x plus y. Now I return back to point number 1, where I have to apply shortcut. So I want to eliminate root. I square both sides. Y square is equal to x plus y. Y square minus x minus y is equal to 0. Dy by dx is equal to minus of, chalo, let us recollect the shortcut. Numerator x variable, y constant. Derivative of y square 0. Derivative of minus x minus 1. Derivative of minus y 0. Denominator derivative of y square 2y. derivative of minus x0, derivative of minus y is minus 1. So my answer will be 1 upon 2y minus 1. So this was the second point, infinity. The moment you see a symbol of infinity, keep the basic function as it is and substitute the repeated condition as y. Let us take one more example, which is also there in our institute ka module. Y is equal to x raised to x raised to x raised to infinity. So this will become x y is equal to x raised to y. Now if I want to make it simple, if I want to simplify it or apply shortcut, let me make the condition simpler. Taking log on both sides, log y is equal to log of x raised to y. Log y is equal to y log x. Now to apply shortcut, I need to shift all terms to the left hand side. Log y minus y log x is equal to 0. Maza raha hai mereko. So now applying shortcut, dy by dx is equal to minus of, yes children, now let us discuss the shortcut. Numerator, x is a variable, y is a constant, derivative of log y 0, minus y as it is, derivative of log x 1 upon x, denominator, derivative of log y 1 upon y, minus log x as it is, derivative of y is 1. Now let us simplify it further. Numerator minus of minus becomes plus y upon x. Denominator 1 minus y log x upon y, where I shift the denominator of denominator to the numerator, which will become y square upon x into 1 minus y log x. So our second point, which was infinity, if a condition is given up to infinity, then keep the basic function as it is and substitute the repeated part as y. The question was root of x plus root of x up to infinity, which will become root of x plus y, making it simple, applying shortcut and getting the result. Point number 3. Friends, this is still type 1. Point number 3. Many a times, question contains two variables. Options contain one variable. If a question contains two variables and options contain one variable, separate x and y. I said separate x and y. When you separate x and y will come on one side, x will go on the other side, and generally you will apply, which will happen in majority of the cases, u by v rule, the rule which you have studied for 2 years, 11th as well as 12th. U by V rule. Let us take an example. X raised to Y is equal to E raised to X. Let us assume that the options are given in terms of one variable. Taking log on both sides, log X raised to Y is equal to log E raised to X. So Y log X is equal to X log E. Now friends, this is revision going on. Need I tell you what is the value of log e? I can understand the value of log e must be occurring in your mind that it is 1. Now normally, as I have explained point number 1, shortcut, we would have taken x on the opposite side, but because options have only one variable, we will separate x and y. This is called separating x and y. Now if you see, we can apply u by v rule. U by v rule is denominator derivative of numerator minus numerator derivative of denominator upon denominator square. Log x minus 1 upon log x the whole square. This covers our important points of implicit functions, two variables. In this, if you want to refer the questions of implicit functions, additional question bank, you can refer question number 54 to 61, which will provide you a practice of implicit functions. Now friends, let us move on to type 2. Variable raised to variable. For us, in the chapter of derivative, variable is x. So whenever the base is x and power is x, it becomes type 2. Remember, if y is equal to v raised to v, dy by dx is equal to y into product rule, UV rule between power and log of base. Remember, you will apply product rule, UV rule between two terms, power and log of base. Let us take an example. Y is equal to x raised to x square. Now if you see, base is x and power is x square. So I have to apply UV rule between x square and log x. Dy by dx is equal to y into x square, that is power, into log x, because it is log of the base. First into derivative of second, plus second into derivative of first. X can be reduced. Now friends, what happens in this type is we'll get the answer in one single step, but the answer may not be given according to as we want. Then sometimes the same question can be given as dy by dx upon y is equal to x square plus log x into 2x. Sometimes the second form of the question is also not given. If y is not given in the answer, neither y is given in the question, then remember, y would be resubstitute dy by dx. The resubstitution value of y is x raised to x square. Whenever we resubstitute, be ready to apply for indices. They may or may not be applicable, but we should be ready. I can take over here I can take x common. So if I take x common, so friends, from the second result, we can take x common into 1 plus 2 log x. If required, we can apply law of indices over here, which can be written as x raised to x square plus 1 into 1 plus 2 log x. Variable raised to variable, the questions are very simple because all questions have to be solved in one particular manner. If y is equal to v raised to v, the answer starts with y and you will apply UV rule, product rule between two terms, power and log of base. First answer, if not given, y on the opposite side. Second answer, if y not given in answer nor in question, resubstitute the value of y and get the end result. Now in this, if we can memorize one standard result, it can help us in one or two difficult questions. D by dx of x raised to x is equal to x raised to x into 1 plus log x. We know the derivative of x raised to n. We know the derivative of e raised to x. We know the derivative of a raised to x. We know the derivative of a raised to a. But we don't know the derivative of x raised to x. We have a habit of solving by log, but that much time we don't have. By that time, the other students, as I keep on saying, will start their articleship. So we have to solve it as quickly as possible. Now, two important questions in this. One, x raised to x, the whole raised to x, which is a raised to m, the whole raised to n, which is equal to a raised to mn. The moment I write it as x raised to x square, it becomes similar to example 1. Similar to example 1. Now, x raised to x square we have just solved it, so it becomes same. The second type of example which can be asked in this is y is equal to x raised to x raised to x. Neither this is up to infinity nor I can apply any law of indices. Here I treat x as base and x raised to x as power. Now, so base is x. So base is x and power is x raised to x. So dy by dx is equal to y into, we have to apply product rule between two terms, power and log of base. So x raised to x into log x, which becomes x raised to x into 1 upon x plus log x. Let us recollect, students. We have just now, a few minutes back, I told you that we need to remember x raised to x square derivative as a standard result. So x raised to x square derivative is x raised to x into 1 plus log x. At the most, this x raised to x upon x raised to 1 can be written as x raised to x minus 1. This part remains same. These are the only two odd man out questions in variable raised to variable. For all other questions, you won't have any problem. To practice additional question bank of differential calculus, question 46 to question 52. Now friends, these are the two types which cover, you know, apart from the standard derivatives which you have studied. Now, let me discuss ki what should your thought process be. First, some simple types which you have studied. Type 3, which we call it as parametric. In parametric, if you observe the questions in the module, parameter for us is t. Dy by dx is dy by dt upon dx by dt. So directly, if I want to analyze and write, derivative of y in the numerator and derivative of x in the denominator with respect to t. Remember, in this, t is a variable. Let us take one single example. Y is equal to 280, x is equal to 80 square. Dy by dx is equal to, if I take y, value of y, which is given as 280, its derivative would be 2a into derivative of t, which is 1. Denominator x is 80 square, a into derivative of t square, which is 2t. My resultant value would be 1 upon t. Friends, the questions of parametric are very, very simple in the module, which are present in the exercise. You will hardly find two odd questions of parametric in the additional question bank. Type 4. Chain rule. Chain rule is what we study as basic derivative. Outermost part to the innermost part. You compare it to the standard functions, differentiate it accordingly, and re-differentiate that part which is given in place of x. Chalguru. Chain rule. Let us take two, three simple examples. Y is equal to root of 1 plus x square. Dy by dx is equal to 1 upon 2 root of 1 plus x square into derivative of 1 plus x square, which is 2x. So this becomes x upon root of 1 plus x square. Second example, y is equal to log of log x. This is a function which is comparable to log x. Initial derivative of log x will be 1 upon log x into derivative of log x, which becomes 1 upon x. Okay. Now, these were the different types which we have discussed. Your thought process as in, if you get a question of derivative, how will you think? How will it click? What should I apply? First, remember, any question given with plus or minus in x, it should be directly differentiated. No method, no shortcut. If functions are multiplied, UV rule. If functions are divided, U by V rule. Then, try to identify if it is x and y together, which is implicit, then t means parametric. Implicit, parametric, it is easy to identify. Then think whether it is variable raised to variable. If it is nothing, it should be chain rule. If this is your thought process for derivatives, if there are four questions, trust me children, you will be minimum able to score 3 out of 4. Standard formula of derivatives, let us just revise. X raised to n, nx raised to n minus 1, e raised to x, e raised to x. a raised to x upon log a, root x, 1 upon 2 root x, 1 upon x minus 1 upon x square, x, 1, constant, 0. With this, we end our first session of derivatives, differential calculus. Okay. So the first part of the chapter of differential and integral calculus is done. Now we go ahead, we move ahead with integral calculus. Non-math students specifically, please follow the lecture. You will have absolutely no problems and you will try to figure out many questions of integration which you have otherwise found difficult. Math students, it could be a treat to you as you have always been using those long lengthy methods to solve questions of integration. But now we are supposed to discuss everything according to a shortcut. Integration. In integration, first, discussing the standard formulae. X raised to n is x raised to n plus 1 upon n plus 1 plus c. In the module, ICI module, if you see, they have given k. Any given constant is acceptable, but the constant of integration must be given. E raised to x plus c, a raised to x upon log a plus c, then 1 upon x a raised to x is a raised to x upon log a plus c, 1 upon x log of mod of x plus c, 1 upon x squared minus 1 upon x plus c, 1 upon 2 root x plus c, 1 upon root x, 2 root x plus c, 1 x plus c, kx plus c. These are the standard formulae which you do in integration. Now type 1. Type 1 in integration for us is product of different functions which you study in 12th, whatever board you have studied, as integration by parts. In product of different functions, the first point is algebraic into exponential. Children, algebraic is always x raised to n, and exponential is e raised to x or a raised to x. For an algebraic function and an exponential function, let us take an example. You copy the algebraic function as it is and proceed with its derivative. I have written the algebraic function. Now I'll go ahead with its derivative as 2x, 2. There is no point in writing the derivative further because derivative of any given constant is 0. You start differentiating the algebraic function from second step. I repeat, from second step, V for victory. But you integrate exponential function from first step. One numeral, you know, number one, integration of e raised to 5x will be e raised to 5x upon 5, e raised to 5x upon 25, e raised to 5x upon 125. When you finish differentiation and integration, you write signs, alternate signs, starting with plus, minus, plus, plus c. So you copy the algebraic function, you go ahead with its derivative, you stop when you arrive at a constant, simultaneously you integrate the exponential function, that too from step 1. Example 2, x cube e raised to 2x. I copy the algebraic function x cube ka derivative is 3x square, 3x square ka derivative is 6x, 6x ka derivative is 6. Now I start integrating the exponential function from the first step. E raised to 2x upon 2, 2 into 2, 4, 2 into 4, 8, 2 into 8, 16, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, c. Maths can be made difficult by us if we study it in a mathematical way, and it can be made simple if it is studied in a logical way. Let us consider one more example with a raised to x, x square into 3 raised to x. Students, integration of a raised to x is a raised to x upon log a. So I copy the algebraic function, differentiate it, I integrate the exponential function from step 1 itself, 3 raised to x upon log 3. When I proceed further, the power of the denominator will increase upon log 3 the whole square upon log 3 the whole cube. Signs plus, minus, plus, plus c. This was the first point of product of different functions, algebraic into exponential. You copy the algebraic function, you proceed with its derivative till you arrive at a constant, but you integrate the exponential function from first step and write them with alternate signs, starting with plus, minus, plus, minus. If you end, you write c, the constant of integration. That could also be given as k according to ICI module. Point number 2, algebraic into log, which is x raised to n into log x. The formula for x raised to n into log x, children, is x raised to n plus 1 upon n plus 1 into log x minus 1 upon n plus 1 plus c. Now, we feel, okay, what is this formula? It is a difficult one. No, it's an absolutely simple one. There are one thing, which is repeating at three places, and the alternate thing is given in the question. N given in the question, n plus 1 repeats at three places. So, if I have x cube into log x, then my answer would be x raised to 4 upon 4 into log x minus 1 upon 4 plus c. If this option is not given, take LCM, simplify and get it further. If my question is integration of x raised to 9 into log x, my resultant value would be x raised to 10 upon 10 into log x minus 1 upon 10 plus c. Can I solve the same question if the term with a power is given in the numerator? Then the answer is yes. I can make the question as x raised to minus 7 log x. My resultant value would be x raised to minus 6 upon minus 6 into log x plus 1 upon 6 plus c. These are the first two points of product of different functions. type 2. We call it as partial fractions, but we will remember it as denominator given in factors. What will we remember it as? Denominator given in factors. First example, x minus 1 upon x minus 3 into x minus 6. Friends, my dear students, first, if the denominator is given into two factors, copy the numerator upon any one factor. The factor which I have not copied, the factor which I have not copied, the factor which I have not copied is x minus 6. I have to make that factor 0, so I put the value of x as 6. 6 minus 1 becomes 5, 6 minus 3 becomes 3. So the first value is 5 by 3. Now, I copy the numerator upon the other factor. The factor this time which I have not copied is x minus 3. So I put x is equal to 3. 3 minus 1 is 2. 3 minus 6 is minus 3. So this becomes minus 2 by 3. When I found the answer 5 by 3, I did not write the factor x minus 6. I club it with log. When I found the answer minus 2 by 3, I haven't written the factor x minus 3. I club it with log. Isn't it simple, friends? You can make questions in mathematics yourself and then solve questions from the module. Write one factor in the denominator, write any two factors in the numerator. Sorry, write one factor in the numerator, write any two in the denominator and solve it. Let us take one more example. X plus 1 upon x plus 2 into x plus 4. Yes, first numerator upon 1, make the other 0. So x is equal to minus 4. Minus 4 plus 1 is minus 3. Minus 4 plus 2 is minus 2. Minus 3 upon minus 2 is 3 by 2. Numerator upon the other factor. First one, I will make it 0. Minus 2 plus 1 is minus 1. Minus 2 plus 4 is 2. So this becomes minus 1 upon 2. Simple, the sum is done. My answer, 3 by 2 log of the factor not written. Minus 1 by 2 log of the factor not written plus C. Friends, this is a type of question which is asked in partial fractions. If three factors are given, x minus 1, x minus 2, x minus 3, the most important thing which should prevail in a human being's mind is common sense. If there were two factors, I wrote one at a time. If there are three factors, I'll write two at a time. Make the third one 0. So 1 upon x minus 1 into x minus 2. The factor which is not written is x minus 3. So x is equal to 3. 3 minus 1 is 2. 3 minus 2 is 1. So my first answer is 1 upon 2. Second factor, 1 upon x minus 2 into x minus 3. The factor not written by me is x minus 1. So I put x is equal to 1. 1 minus 2 is minus 1. 1 minus 3 is minus 2. So this becomes 1 upon 2. Now, the only two factors which are left to be written is the first and the third one. I should put x as 2. 2 minus 1 is 1. 2 minus 3 is minus 1. The resultant value is minus 1. My answer, half log, factor not written, x minus 3. You can get from here also, children. plus half log x minus 1 minus log x minus 2 plus c. So this was type 2 of integration. Type 3. Type 3 is the most important and the most easiest. You will find maximum number of questions of type 3 in the module. Type 3 is integration of a function raised to a power along with its derivative results in function raised to n plus 1 upon n plus 1 plus c. The moment you see something with a power along with its derivative, it should resemble this type. Example, x square plus 1 raised to 10 into 2x. Whenever you solve this type, think, what is n? Then this is n. What is function? Then x square plus 1 is function. What is the derivative of x square plus 1? 2x. Is it given or do I need to multiply and divide? It's given. If derivative is given, straight away apply the formula. So this becomes x square plus 1 raised to 11 upon 11 plus c. Now see the subtle variations in the question. X square plus 1 raised to 8 into x dx. This is f, this is n, this is not the derivative. So what should I do to get the derivative? Multiply and divide by 2, half x square plus 1 raised to 8 into 2x dx. Now this becomes f, this becomes n, this becomes derivative. So my answer is half x square plus 1 raised to 9 upon 9 plus c. The third variation in the same question, x square plus 1 raised to 6 into 5x dx. X square plus 1, the derivative is 2x, I don't want 5. Any unwanted number given in the question, take it outside. The moment you take it outside, you'll be able to judge what should the derivative be. Multiply and divide by 2. When you multiply and divide by 2, you get the derivative. Now interpretation, 5 by 2, x square plus 1 raised to 7 upon 7 plus c. The most important rule for this type, the function with a power must be compulsorily present in the numerator. So in case that function with a power is given in the denominator, shift it to the numerator. So this can be written as x cube plus 1 raised to minus 7 into into 3x square. The power is minus 7. The function is x cube plus 1. Derivative of x cube plus 1 is 3x square. Now we can implement the result. X cube plus 1, the whole raised to minus 6 upon minus 6 plus c. Students, I have given you 4 variations which can be asked in this type with one single example given in different ways. If you focus on these examples, then all questions of this type are probably covered. If you'll solve scanner, the past question papers, you'll find many questions of this type in the scanner, as well as type 1 and type 2. Now, we move to type 4. Type 4 is a simple, steady type. E raised to x into function plus derivative. The compulsive part in this is e raised to x. The resultant value will be e raised to x into function plus c. The institute will only ask questions in a difficult manner. Say for example, x e x minus e x upon x square. This is a question from the module itself. Exercise 8A, question number 38. If I take e raised to x common, x minus 1 upon x square, single denominator, two parts in the numerator, x upon x square minus 1 upon x square. This gets eliminated. If you check, derivative of 1 upon x is minus 1 upon x square. So this becomes e raised to x into 1 upon x plus c. E raised to x into a function plus its derivative. The resultant value is e raised to x into function plus c. E raised to x into x log x plus 1 into x raised to minus 1. The term which is given with a negative power should be made positive. So e raised to x into x log x plus 1 the whole upon x with respect to x. This gets cancelled. Function is log x. Derivative is 1 upon x. So its interpretation will be e raised to x into log x plus c. You will see 4 to 5 questions of this type where they have given power of a linear term in the denominator. If you see power of a linear term in the denominator with difference of numbers 1, specifically difference of numbers 1, then we add and subtract 1. So this becomes e raised to x into x plus 3 minus 1 upon x plus 3 the whole square upon x plus 3 the whole square. This gets eliminated. Remember, when the terms are in the denominator with difference of powers 1, then smaller power function, greater power derivative. So this will become e raised to x into 1 upon x plus 3 plus c. Now, if I show you the alternative method, you will enjoy that alternative method. Whenever you get a question of this type where you feel that you are supposed to add and subtract 1, add 1 and subtract 1, then you can do one thing. You can erase the numerator, erase the denominator. Straight away you'll get your answer. This is probably the shortest shortcut which has ever produced in mathematics. Reduce the numerator, reduce the power, you get the resultant value. Friends, my dear students, these types cover the entire part of integration. Now, what else is there in integration? In integration, we have something called as definite integrals. Definite integrals is nothing but integration with limits. So, its method is after integration, after you solve according to a standard type or a normal type, normal question, substitute limits in place of x, in place so substitute limits in place of x. Say for example, integral of x square dx from 1 to 2. First, basic formula, integration of x square is x cube upon 3. Now, wherever you see x, put the value of x as 2 minus put the value of x as 1, which becomes 7 upon 3. Friends, there is one point in definite integration which the institute has been asking consistently, and they have not put a question in the module of that type. Integration of fx upon fx plus f of a plus b minus x. How to remember this in the exam? Denominator must have two parts, out of which one must be repeated in the numerator. If the denominator has two parts, out of which one is repeated in the numerator, then you think, only think, don't solve, of replacing x by a plus b minus x, lower limit plus upper limit minus x. If you think of replacing x as lower limit plus upper limit minus x, and you get the second part in the numerator, then the answer for all such questions will be b minus a upon 2. Example, integration of root x upon root x plus root of 7 minus x from 1 to 6. Lower limit is 1, upper limit is 6, 1 plus 6 is 7. I can replace x as 7 minus x. So the second part comes to the numerator. If the second part comes to the numerator, my answer will be 6 minus 1 upon 2, which is equal to 5 upon 2. This ends the discussion of techniques, shortcuts of integration. Now, integration, as we had discussed, derivatives. Plus minus, no method, direct. Product, two types, xn ex, xn log x. Factors, then function raised to n into derivative, e raised to x into function plus derivative. These are the different types of questions which can be asked apart from standard formulae which you have studied in your SYGC 12th standard. So friends, to sum up, differential and integral calculus, there is no fixed weightage. No one knows what the pattern will institute follow. But if we follow these things, revise it, even at the last moment, this will help us to answer maximum number of questions on the day of exam. Solving n number of MCQs may not help, but remembering the points and techniques on the day of exam may help you to evaluate the answer. So out of 7 to 8, if we are able to successfully solve 5-6, our job is done. As a non-math student also, I can guarantee you, if you just go through these things and solve the questions of module, you are bound to get minimum 60 to 70% questions right out of the desired questions, which anyways many non-math students leave. Please don't leave the chapter. We don't know which chapter ka questions will be easy on our exam. So go through the basics, study the shortcuts. That's it. That will help you to score maximum marks in this chapter. Thank you so much.